Honorable Chairman, Honorable Chairman, Vice Chairman, Srimati Rohini Jodhipalli, Director, Dr. Unnath Sir and Dr. Padmanabha, respected Chief Guest, Honorable Justice, A. Gopal Reddy Garu, Guest of Honor, Dr. S. Arvind Kumar Garu, and Srinivas Acharya Garu, Principal, Dr. Nur Sahib Sahna, invited guests, members from press and media, esteemed faculty members, staff, graduating candidates of HMS class of 2017, and students, good evening to all. I, Dr. Srinivas Babu Kati, on behalf of Hamsa Audiology Medical College Hospital,
welcome you all to city the graduation ceremony 2023. Now we present to you the first proud batch of Philonians class of 2017, Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College Hospital Research Center. Let's welcome them with an applause.
Let us all join together and submit ourselves to the Almighty and offer our gratitude for bringing the source of enlightened spirit. I request all to please rise I request all the dignitaries please join in for lighting of the lamp. I request Dr. Roja to facilitate the same.
Chule.
Could your parents and small photographs, would you please be seated? Volunteers, please explain. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Dr. Roja. I now request Dr. Saital to take over and conduct the next part of the program. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. A warm good evening to one and all. I am Dr. Shwetal, Assistant Professor, Department of Practice of Medicine. Let us proceed. May I please request the President of today's program, our beloved, our favorite, Dr. Umesh Akkaladevi sir, to please come on to the dais. I request Nagi Bhanushree to please accompany sir and welcome him to the salon.
వాళ్ళందరూ ఎందుకు స్టేజ్ ఎక్కేస్తా
మే ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ ద చీఫ్ గెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ టుడేస్ ఈవినింగ్ ఆనరేబుల్ జస్టిస్ శ్రీ ఏ గోపాలరెడ్డి గార్ ఆన్ ద డైస్. ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ మిస్ హుల్డా టు ప్లీజ్ వెల్కమ్ సర్ విత్ సాప్లింగ్. Justice A. Gopal Reddy Garu is Chairman, High Power Committee, TIFRC, Government of Telangana.
Let them come there.
May I request today's guest of honor, Dr. Shri S. Praveen Kumar Garu,
on to the dais. I request Ms. Magadi Meghna to please welcome sir with a sapling. Sir is eminent homeopathic physician, researcher, retired principal JSPS Government Homeopathy College, Hyderabad. May I now request our guest of honor, Sri T. Srinivas Acharya Garu, onto the dais. I request Ms. Kamala Vandana to welcome sir with a sapling. Sir is Principal Director, Vishwa Vishwani Institute of Systems and Management. Principal Dr. Nuru Seher Khan ma'am onto the dais. I request Ms. Pingli Alekia to please welcome ma'am with a sapling. Our senior faculty, Professor Dr. M.N. Chari sir, onto the dais. I request Pujita Raj to please welcome sir with a sapling. Sir is not here. May I now request our Vice Principal Dr. Srinivas Babu Katri sir to please be on the dais. I request Ms. Sirla Harshini to accompany sir with a sapling. Request our senior faculty, Professor Dr. Gurunadham sir, to please come on to the dais. I request Harshini to please welcome sir with a sapling. Professor Dr. Venugopal Gauri sir to please come on to the dais. I request Panasa Srija to please welcome sir. Sir, to kindly permit me to commence the convocation proceedings by ringing the gong.
Bro, Nakiran, bro.
This convocation of Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College, Hospital and Research Center has been called to confer the degree upon the candidates who have been certified to be worthy of them by the Academic Council. I request Director Dr. Umesh sir to kindly administer the oath to the graduating candidates.
Will all the candidates for the award of degrees stand, raise their right hand and place it on their heart, and answer the three questions with the words, "I do promise," after each question. Do you solemnly and sincerely promise and declare that if admitted to the degree for which you have been qualified, you will in your daily life and conversation conduct yourself and become worthy members of this institution?
I do promise.
Do you solemnly and sincerely promise and declare that to the utmost of your opportunity and ability, you will use your power for the promotion of true learning in the service of your fellow men? Do you solemnly and sincerely promise that you will faithfully and diligently fulfill the duties of the profession to which you will eventually belong, and that you will on all occasions maintain its purity and reputation? Thank you.
Thank you, sir. May I now request our Vice Principal, Professor Dr. Srinivas Babu Kathi, sir, to administer Hanumanian oath.
I request all the dignitaries, please, will take the Hanuman oath. The sayings which are followed by the, keep your left hand on your heart and raise your right hand and follow the words. On my honor, I swear that I shall practice the teachings of homeopathy, perform my duty, render justice to my patients, and help the sick, whosoever comes to me for treatment. May the teachings of Master Hanuman inspire me, and may I have the strength for fulfillment of my mission. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, students. May I request Dr. Avinash and Dr. Madhuri to please take over.
Distinguished guests of honor, proud parents, the chairpersons, the directors, the principal, the vice principal, the HODs, the faculty, and budding graduates of Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College, Hospital and Research Center. Good evening and a warm welcome to you all. Myself, Dr. Avinash, Assistant Professor, Department of Human Physiology and Biochemistry, Hamsa.
అక్కడ పడేసి నాగరు.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the director of Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College, Hospital and Research Center, I admit you to the degree for which you have qualified, and I charge you throughout your life to prove worthy of this degree.
Thank you, sir. I request the Chief Guest, Honorable Justice Gopal Reddy Garu, to kindly present the award to the best outgoing student and three best academic excellence awards along with graduation completion certificates to the candidates. Candidates, please come to the dais and receive the awards and certificates from the Chief Guest in the order being announced. May I request Srimati Rohini Joginapalli Garu to present the sash to the candidates. I request Dr. Devjani Madam to facilitate the same. Before we invite the outstanding student to the stage, let me share a few words about their remarkable journey, excelling not only in their studies but also embodying the spirit of curiosity, dedication and intellectual pursuit. Without further delay, please join me in welcoming Ms. Soumya Pindi to the stage. Soumya Pindi, daughter of Pindi Chandramouli Garu and Lavanya Garu.
Please join me in welcoming Miss Tarasvi Nagula, Kusumapriya Bandi, Anusha Ramadugu to the stage. Tarasvi Nagula, daughter of Ravi Kumar Garu and Sandhya Rani Garu.
Chennuri, daughter of Chennuri Mahendra Reddy Garu and Parvati Garu. Garu. వైష్ణవి సిద్ధి, డాటర్ ఆఫ్ సిద్ధి శ్రీనివాస్ గారు అండ్ రాధిక గారు. విజయ్ కుమార్ పూర్వ, సన పూర్వ రామచంద్రుడు గారు అండ్ సుభాషిణి గారు. విజయ్ కుమార్ కూర్వ, మహమ్మద్ అజారుద్దీన్ సన్ ఆఫ్ మహమ్మద్ అఫజుద్దీన్ గారు, మహమ్మద్ బేగం గారు. విరాజిత అభ్యంగుల, డాక్టర్ డాటర్ ఆఫ్ అభ్యంగుల వెంకట్రామ్ గారు, అభ్యంగుల అరుణాదేవి గారు. యశస్వి అదేపు, డాటర్ ఆఫ్ అదేపు ఏకాంబరం గారు, అదేపు పద్మ గారు. సారికా ఆకారపు, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ ఆకారపు శ్రీనివాస్ గారు, ఆకారపు జ్యోతి గారు. ప్రీతం రెడ్డి అల్లా, సన్ ఆఫ్ అల్లా శ్రీనివాస్ రెడ్డి గారు, అల్లా వరలక్ష్మి గారు. సాత్విక అనంతుల, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ అనంతుల లింగారెడ్డి గారు, అనంతుల పద్మజ గారు.
Now, may I request the guest of honor, Dr. S. Praveen Kumar Garu, to kindly do the honors. I request Dr. Padmaja ma'am to present the sash to the standing. Pranita Atikeshwaram.
ఇదేంది ఓన్లీ ఛానల్ టూ రికార్డ్ అవుతుంది. ఛానల్ వన్ నువ్వే ఆఫీస్ వాళ్ళిద్దరే ఛానల్ టూ ఇద్దరు
ఇబ్బంది
ఇద్దరు కలిపి ఒకటే వేసిన
ప్రణీత అటికేశ్వరం, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ అటికేశ్వరం పండరయ్య గారు అండ్ స్వర్ణలత గారు.
Give a big round of applause.
and Ani Lakshmi garu.
Srinivas Acharya Garu to kindly do the honors. I request Dr. Gurunatham sir, Professor, Department of Physiology to present the sash to the candidates. Nandini Guglavat, daughter of Guglavat Lakshman Garu and Sarat Sravanti Garu. Lokeshwari garu.
Every time it's going to the body, yeah.
గుండగోని, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ గుండగోని పిక్షం గారు అండ్ మంగా గారు. గుండు, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ గుండు సైదులు గారు అండ్ సుజాత గారు. ప్రియాంక జక్కుల, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ జక్కుల సుదర్శన్ గారు అండ్ మంజుల గారు. దేవి జరుపుల, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ జరుపుల సీతారాం నాయక్ గారు అండ్ జ్యోతి గారు. జెట్టి, సన్ ఆఫ్ జెట్టి వెంకటేశ్వర్లు గారు అండ్ మీనాక్షి గారు. సాయిభరత్ కంటం, సన్ ఆఫ్ కంటం సురేష్ గారు అండ్ రమాజ్యోతి గారు. కృష్ణసాయి కరిపే, సన్ ఆఫ్ కరిపే కొండయ్య గారు అండ్ పద్మ గారు. సింధూజ కాశారాజు, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ కాశారాజు సురేష్ కుమార్ గారు అండ్ లక్ష్మి గారు. లక్ష్మి గారు. వినీలా కాటూరి, డాటర్ ఆఫ్ కాటూరి దుర్గారావు గారు అండ్ సుదర్శ గారు. సుధారాణి కెలోచు, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ కెలోచు రామ్ కుమార్ గారు అండ్ గీత గారు. చంద్రలేఖ కొక్కుల, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ కొక్కుల రమేష్ గారు అండ్ కొక్కుల సువర్ణ గారు.
Now may I request our director Dr. Umesh Akkaladevi sir to kindly do the honor. I request Dr. Ramesh Gaud sir, professor, Department of Homeopathic Materia Medica to honor the student with the sash. Venkatesh Koninti, son of Koninti Devappa garu and Ushanamma garu. వెంకటేష్ కొనింటి, సన్ ఆఫ్ కొనింటి దేవప్ప గారు అండ్ ఉషానమ్మ గారు. అలేఖ్య కొప్పిశెట్టి, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ కొప్పిశెట్టి సత్యనారాయణ గారు అండ్ విజయ కుమారి గారు. తబస్సు మలేహా, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ సలీం గారు అండ్ ఆస్మా గారు. అనూష మల్లం, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ మల్లం యాదగిరి గారు అండ్ స్వప్న గారు. శ్రావ్య మంటూరి, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ మంటూరి లోకేశ్వర్ గారు అండ్ సుశీల గారు. Sanjani Maramoni, daughter of Maramoni Balraj Garu and Vandana Garu. Rajalakshmi Garu. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Now, may I request our principal, Professor Dr. Noor Sahar Khan, madam, to kindly do the honors. I request Dr. Lakshmi Prasad Garu, Associate Professor, Department of Forensic Medicine, to present the candidates with the sash. Srileka Nadimenti, daughter of Nadimenti Arjuna Garu and Lakshmi Garu. Monika Lakshmi Nagarjuna, daughter of Nagarjuna Seshu Babu Garu and Sudharani Garu. Jasin Palamakula, daughter of Palamakula Philip Garu and Amelia Garu. Sushmita Panasa, daughter of Panasa, Prasad Garu and Lalita Garu. Meghana Pantangi, daughter of Pantangi Naveen Babu Garu and Harita Garu. Papoji Pranita, daughter of Naganna Garu and Swarupa Rani Garu. Sandhya Poluri, daughter of Poluri Srinivas Rao Garu and Kalyani Garu. Ponneboyina, daughter of Ponneboyina Yadagiri Garu and Yadalakshmi Garu. Sirichandana Pottavathini, daughter of Pottavathini Chakrapani Garu and Pottavathini Palta Garu. Hey, యామిని ప్రతికంఠం, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ ప్రతికంఠం నారాయణ రాజు గారు అండ్ జ్యోతి గారు. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Now, may I request the Vice Principal, Dr. Srinath Babu Kathi, sir, to kindly do the honors. May I request Dr. Ganesh Achari Khattar, sir, to present the students with the flag. Shalini Pulguri, daughter of Pulguri Ramulu Garu and Bo Lakshmi Garu.
దామోదర్ గారు అండ్ విజయలక్ష్మి గారు. స్పందన సిరిగాద, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ సిరిగాద శ్రీ సిద్ధిరాములు గారు అండ్ సబిత గారు.
లక్ష్మీ
ఎస్జిఎం డాక్టర్ జి గణేశన్ గారు అండ్ మహాలక్ష్మి గారు.
Very lucky. Her birthday is also today.
Saugandhika Busireddi, daughter of Busireddi Srinivas Reddy garu and Maheshwari garu.
Now, may I request our faculty, Dr. Kiran Kumar Garu, to kindly do the honors. I request Dr. Sriraj, Associate Professor, Department of Anatomy, to present the sash to the candidates. హరిత తుమ్మలపల్లి, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ తుమ్మలపల్లి జగన్నాథ రెడ్డి గారు అండ్ అనిత గారు. వెన్నెల రెడ్డి వంగల, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ వంగల శ్రీధర్ రెడ్డి గారు అండ్ కరుణశ్రీ గారు. ఇంద్రజ విలసాగరపు, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ విలసాగరపు కుమారస్వామి గారు అండ్ సత్యారాణి గారు. వెంకట శ్రీకన్య ఎల్ఎంటి, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ ఎల్ఎంటి వెంకయ్య గారు అండ్ సుగుణ గారు. విద్యాప్రకాష్ ఎరుగొండ, ఎరుగొండ నర్సయ్య గారు అండ్ శారద గారు. అపరంజని బొల్లంపల్లి, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ బొల్లంపల్లి ప్రసాద్ గారు అండ్ ఏంజల్ గారు. Thank you. దీప్తి దొడ్డ, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ దొడ్డ సంతోషం గారు అండ్ సరోజ గారు. అమూల్య దుబ్బాక, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ దుబ్బాక ప్రభాకర్ గారు అండ్ భాగ్యలక్ష్మి గారు. చక్రవర్తి గండమల్ల, గండమల్ల వెంకటేశ్వర్లు గారు అండ్ నిర్మల గారు. రాధియా కేతావత్, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ కేతావత్ నరేందర్ అండ్ నిర్మల గారు. Thank you, sirs.
Now, may I request our professor, Dr. Venugopal Gowri, sir, to kindly do the honor. I request Dr. Santosh Kiran, sir, assistant professor, Department of Homeopathic Materia Medica, to present the flash to the candidates. సుష్మా శ్రీ మేకల, డాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ మేకల శ్రీనివాసరావు గారు అండ్ భాగ్యలక్ష్మి గారు. Thank you. గాన చిరం తేజ మర్రి, సన్ ఆఫ్ గాన గట్టయ్య గారు అండ్ యాదమ్మ గారు.
Big round of applause to all the graduates. We express our heartfelt congratulations to the graduates of 2K17 batch. May your journey ahead be filled with success.
May I request Dr. Kathish sir to take over.
Thank you, Avinash sir. And Madhuri ma'am, and with the continued efforts and academic performance, our best students from the first year to final year, the 10 out of the 98 students. So for this, the renowned and companies like Wilma Shabe and Advan, they are giving some complimentary and best for the utmost all the level. So I'm inviting the here some of the internees, please come and collect your, and I would like to invite before that Pradeep sir, please come, and Anwar, and I request Dr. S. Praveen Kumar sir, please present this to the name. I'm inviting best outgoing student and the topper Pindi Soumya, come and collect your, please applaud the Pindi Soumya for the consistent efforts for the first year to final year and during internship. తరస్వి నాగుల, కుసుమ ప్రియ బండి, అనుషా రామడుగు కంగ్రాచులేషన్స్. భావనారెడ్డి చెన్నూరి కంగ్రాచులేషన్స్. ద్రాక్షాయిని అడిగోపుల
నేను 50 వేసేస్తున్నారా, అది పర్వ ఎక్కువైపోతున్నా.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్, అండ్ ఐ విల్ హ్యాండ్ ఓవర్ దట్ టు ది డాక్టర్ అవినాష్. కంగ్రాచులేషన్స్.
Now, may I request Dr. Mastambali and Dr. Rosa to take over.
అది
హౌస్ పార్టీ సాయి సాయి మైక్ మైక్
గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ వరల్డ్ ఆల్. మైసెల్ఫ్ డాక్టర్ మస్తాన్వలి, అసిస్టెంట్ ప్రొఫెసర్, డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ కమ్యూనిటీ మెడిసిన్.
గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ ఎవ్రీవన్. మైసెల్ఫ్ డాక్టర్ రోజా, అసిస్టెంట్ ప్రొఫెసర్, డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఆబ్స్టెట్రిక్స్ అండ్ గైనకాలజీ.
నౌ ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ అవర్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ డాక్టర్ నూరస్ హెయిర్ ఖాన్ మేడం టు ప్రజెంట్ ద అకాడమిక్ రిపోర్ట్ బిఫోర్ ద కాన్వకేషన్.
A very good evening to one and all. I hope everyone is enjoying this beautiful evening. And Dr. Nur Sir Khan. Okay. I, Dr. Nur Sir Khan, Principal of the Spinal Institute, Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College and Hospital and Research Center, feels privileged to welcome Honorable Santosh Kumar Joganpally Sir and Rohini Madam, the Chief Guest, Justice A. Gopal Reddy Garu, the guest of honor, Dr. S. Pravin Kumar Sir, respected T. Shima Sir, Principal Director Vishwaswani Institute of System and Management, Honorable Director Dr. Umesh Sir, who is a role model behind the success of this institute, Dr. Padmaja Madam Garu and Dr. Shiran Babu Katti Sir, the Vice Principal and Medical Superintendent of Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College. I really welcome you all to the Siddhi Graduation Ceremony 2023. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome dear parents of my loving student of 2017 batch, to witness the graduation ceremony of their child with every parent's dream of. Thank you, dear parents, for making them an efficient doctor, which was a milestone for us. Our institution is made up of a strong team of more than 100 staff in all capacities who are dedicated in their roles and loyal to the college. Under the guidance of the Honorable Director with the mission of giving best education, I feel very honored to give the glimpse of the about the institution. On the graduation center, the main aim of the establishment of our institution is for promoting and propagating the science of homeopathy and for the implementation of better standards of homeopathic education and training the graduates and postgraduates in homeopathy to become better doctors and also conducting research in various aspects of homeopathy, which collectively helps in providing better effective medical for the suffering humanity. And our research is an integral part of training. The Central Council of Research Homeopathy has inculcated the STSH program for research. I'm proud to announce that our 2017 best students got selected in the year 2022, and the names I'm going to announce from the 2017 batch: Ramadugu Anusha, Mohammad Azharuddin, Malra K. Chandraleka, Nagulu Tarasvi, Pritam Reddy, and Mullapati Tarun. And the guide to guide them, I'm very proud of them, Dr. Mastan Wali, Dr. Sirar, Dr. Nisha Arvind, Dr. Lagnajita, Dr. Santosh Kiran, Dr. Yamuna, Dr. Lakshmi. I congratulate to all the guides, and I hope my students will carry on this research work in the future and make the institution very proud. The 2017 batch was the first batch with an intake of 100 seats. We achieved 100% result in the first year, where we got two distinctions and got the names for Dark Shiny and Chennai Bhavna Reddy. And 25 students were the top rankers with 90-95% of pass percentage every year. I feel honored to inform that our institution got recognition for the post-graduation in homeopathy with the intake of 42 seats, and very soon we are not successful running this, and very soon we are going to start the first batch. And we are now successful running the seventh batch. And within this 7 years, our institution had done many activities and collaborations. And among this, 98 of my graduates had good training in the 150 Barrett Super Speciality Government Hospital in Gajwel, which is a state of healthcare facility established under the supervision of Honorable Ex-Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu. We are officially, our students are being posted in the various peripheries. They were trained and now they are able to handle the various emergencies. They have adopted the village for the screening for the various health camps like diabetes, menopausal, cervical screening, anemia, and menstrual hygiene in the school going girls. With the publications of articles, many students have published the articles and cases in the various journals. We were officially permitted for the DMHO to undertake free medical camps, health awareness camps in the surrounding Mulgur, Murkuk, Bargar, and Gajwel mandals. I express my sincere thanks to the Siddhi Pet District Medical and Health Department. We have MOUs with Mahatma Jyotiba BC Welfare Girls and Boys, where we conducted screening of the students in the age group of 13 to 20 years for their physical as well as mental health. I extend my sincere thanks to the principal for the support and cooperation. Graduation is a movement, my dear students, for the faculty, staff, and the parents, that the hard work, sincerity, and commitment has made it possible. From the bottom of my heart, I really congratulate my dear loving students for receiving the degree and the awards. You are about to embark on your careers indeed. Dear students, this success completes one phase of your life. The liberty of the student is over, and now it's time to tighten the belts as you will be venturing the noble profession of medicine, which will be a huge responsibility on you. I wish all the success in life, be it your professional in your doctors, researchers, or academics. Last message I want to send is be grounded, be sincere, honest, and make the institution proud. And whenever you meet the gates of Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College are always open to you. Thank you so much.
Mike, Sai, Sai, Mike.
Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable words.
I feel honored to introduce our guest of honor, Dr. S. Praveen Kumar Garu, retired principal and HOD, Department of Medicine, JSPS Government Homeopathic Medical College, Ramanthapur, Hyderabad. He worked as HOD, PG Department of Medicine for 3 years, HOD of PG Metro America for 3 years, HOD UG Department of Medicine for 3 years, Vice Principal for 3 years, and Principal for 1 year. Presently working as Professor and HOD, PG Department of Psychiatry, MNR Homeopathic Medical College, Sangareddy. Trustee and Secretary General, Global Homeopathy Foundation, India. Associate Editor, National Journal of Homeopathy, Mumbai. Member, MARB, National Commission of Homeopathy, New Delhi. Member, SFC and General Counseling, NIH, Kolkata. Member, Expert Committee, Department of Ayush, Telangana. Now I request the guest of honor, Dr. Praveen Kumar Garu, to address the graduating candidates.
Good evening, respected Honorable Justice Gopal Reddy Garu, guest of honor Acharya Garu, Director Umesh, Babu, Principal, all the dignitaries, parents, students, and more importantly, the fresh graduates from this college. It's indeed a great privilege for me to be here because for the first time, there were several things which I have seen. Though we have conducted in our JSPS graduation, we didn't do all this because we did it in Ravindra Bharati and we did it in a different manner. So I was very much touched by the procedure, what it has been going on. Myself and Dr. Venugopal Gari, we were discussing, when I have seen these graduates, and it is the commonest problem or the situation even in medical colleges across the country. You please don't mistake me, 85% of students are girls. I am not against girls. Okay, I wouldn't have been here if I am against girls. But the greatest problem, I address you, I request you, that as commonly it happens, your parents would search one established software engineer in America, and after a year or so after your graduation, you would fly off to America and your degree will fall into the ocean, and you forget homeopathy, even the spelling even. Please don't do it. There was one of our students, she is still there in America, Kavita Kukunuru. She wrote a book called What Difficulties She Faced and How She Established Herself. There are quite a number of JSPS students who have started their practice there. You can, even if you want to go there. The only urge or the desire or request, whatever you call it as, from all of us here and from me especially, that you must practice homeopathy alone. There is one beautiful verse in Bhagavad Gita. Swadharmo nidhanam shreyaha, paradharmo bhayavaha. even if you want to practice other systems, you will be under tremendous stress and tension. Don't do it. You are trained in homeopathy, so practice. Otherwise, Dr. Umesh efforts all will go into vain. Don't do that. Because he has established with his wife, in fact, behind every successful man. So she's always there anyway. So they have struggled hard. They have established this beautiful institute with a lot of infrastructure, good faculty. And you are all trained. So practice homeopathy. Don't search for the excuse. Practice homeopathy first and then do anything later. Now you may ask me a question. After BHMS, what to do? This, of course, everybody knows. There is 26.3% in the whole world acceptance for Ayush by the public. And it has been increasing. And if you see the pharma figures also, Mr. Pradeep is here, he would agree with me. It is doubling every year. Pharma sector is very important for us because if your medicines are not sold and if you don't have a market value for your medicines, then the credibility of the system will be very difficult. However much you struggle hard to practice homeopathy, but your pharma doesn't support you and you don't support the pharma, there will be a lot of problem. So this is what like global homeopathic market in US dollar, $10.7 billion in 2021. It has increased enormously. As Richard Branson says, why am I showing that? Because business opportunities are like buses. When you stand there in the bus stop, there is always another one coming. If you have missed one, don't think it is the end of it. Nowadays it is difficult because a lot of ladies are there. So difficult for men to get into the buses. But good fortune that they are announcing some special buses for men. So it could be. Sure. Right. Then.
Sure.
There is a research wing. Why am I mentioning this? You may be aware. CCRH is established in India, in Delhi. And it takes care of many research activities in the whole country. And you can apply for research and do research because your hospital college is having research wing as well. So it is like without research you can't go ahead. You can't proceed further. So you need to have. And according to A.C. Nelson survey, 62% of current homeopathic users have never tried conventional medicines, any other medicine. And 82% of homeopathy users would not switch to conventional medicine. That indicates, that's an encouragement. That indicates that if a patient comes to you, it is once and for all blocked. His whole family will be with you. But it doesn't mean that you will treat every disease under the sun. It is difficult. We have our scope, we have our limitations. You are already taught in your college. There are two National Institute of Homeopathy and one in Kolkata, one in Narela. Lot of recruitment is going on. Search for that. And we know there are more than 2.5 lakh homeopathic practitioners in the country. And there are so many more than 228 colleges in the country. So all the colleges will have hospitals. They need lecturers. They need medical officers. Lot of opportunities. Percentage wise you see, and after your graduation you have form like MD, post graduation you can do. Some of the institutes do give some good stipend, and you have so many different PG courses for which your degree is eligible, like Master of Health Science in Clinical Child Development, so on. Even MBA you can write. Civil services, I was talking to Gauri, the same thing, like many engineering students, 10%, it has been calculated that 10% engineering students are opting for civil services. I am not saying that you opt for civil services. My first urge was practice homeopathy. But you have different options as well. You can definitely. MSc psychology is one of the best. You can be a psychologist and it has its own things. And MBA, MSc, medical anatomy. Anatomy is nobody's game. It is neither allopathy nor homeopathy nor Yunani. You can be a postgraduate in MSc and you can do it. And MSc applied nutrition, food and nutrition. There are many, many degrees. If you are seeing the list I have given, it has been copied. You can take the copy of this from Dr. Srinivas and you can see them, what are all the opportunities. And nowadays, Google Mata is there. You can search, you will get all the information as well. Right? Worldwide also, one mention about worldwide. Like 200 million people, they have been estimated that 200 million people all over the world use homeopathy as on today. And it would increase only because the population is increasing. It would increase. And there are 28 countries in which it is officially recognized. And homeopathy is the second most used system in the world. And over 1 billion in expenditures. $1 billion, not rupees. So second most opted thing. And global homeopathy products market is 6.2 billion in 2020. It is increasing 10.7 in 2021. The latest one, what I have shown in earlier slide, was $10.7 billion. So you can see how it is increasing. Homeopathy is used in 100 countries all over the world, and Ayurveda is used in 90, Yunani in 82 member countries. And several states in USA, there is a little crunch. The lot of efforts are going on. There is a conference in February itself in California. So many things are going on. Our organization, Global Homeopathy Foundation, for which I am Secretary General, we have established in Australia our branch. We are trying to establish in California. So there are a lot of efforts by many, many organizations. Liga is also trying to do that. And it would be recognized, if not today, tomorrow. So there are three states in USA, Arizona, Connecticut, and Nevada, where you can practice with your own degree with a little examination. Other things, there is a little. Ontario, there is an Ontario Homeopathic Medical Association, that in Canada. And it is very... very, very popular in UAE, and most of you must be aware, next month, January 13th, 14th, 15th, there is an international Ayush Expo, where homeopathy is also there. So it is very popular in UAE, in Dubai actually. So it is the latest, I conclude here, it is the latest scientific system, we all know it, except some of the systems like oil pulling and keto diet, all those things, they are not systems, but established therapeutic scientific system. It is the latest one, and all state governments encourage. There are so many committees, so many establishments, and UAE, Asian countries, it is very popular. You can practice everywhere. So before I conclude, in fact, I thank all the organizers, all the faculty of HAMSA, everyone here, for having given me this opportunity to be here, watch this graduation ceremony, and share my ideas and views and my concern to my dear friends. All the best to all of you in your life, and you can approach any one of us anytime, like principal said, HAMSA College anytime. You can, because nowadays it is only mail or phone. You can, and we will be of any help, whatever is needed. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I feel honored to introduce our guest of honor, Sri Srinivas Acharya Garu, founder of Vishwa Vishwani Institutions, Hyderabad. He is an entrepreneur, accomplished professional with 25 years of experience in carving academic institutions right from inception, covering functional areas like academic administration, admission strategic branding, and integrated campus development, and has passion for digital marketing. He strongly believes in value-based education and academic excellence in the institutional level. He is a governing and academic council member of a number of reputed institutions, national executive council member of Association of Indian Management Schools, Secretary of Approved Business Schools of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. He served as Chairman of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh Chapters, is a member of NHRD Hyderabad and Hyderabad Management Association. May I request the guest of honor, Sri Srinivas Acharya Garu, to address the graduating candidates. Sir.
Shubha Sayantram. Good evening. No energy is left. Good evening. It is difficult to address doctors by a non-doctor. Honorable Chief Guest, Justice A. Gopal Reddy Garu, Chairman High Power Commission, Chairman TFRC, Government of Telangana, respected guest of honor, Dr. S. Praveen Kumar Garu, former principal, JSS Government Homeopathy Medical College, respected chairman, Sri Anishan Educational Society, Rohini Joginpalli Garu, respected Umesh Garu, the director of Hamsa Homeopathy, respected most dynamic Durgamma Garu, Dr. Padma Garu, faculty members, principal, respected Kathi Srinivas Garu, Kathi Garu, and principal Garu Narush Shain Khan, my dear students, graduating students, doctors, my dear graduating students, Vaidyo Narayana Hari means doctor is embodiment of God. If there is anybody which we can see after mother is doctor. Am I right? No response? It gives immense pleasure to address the huge gathering here. This would not have been happened. This has happened with the support of our Justice A. Gopal Reddy Garu, who has given the first approval essentiality certificates for AMSA Homeopathy. Let me share with all graduating students, with the expert opinion of Dr. Praveen Kumar, Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College, Ayush, especially homeopathy, is no more alternate medicine. It is going to be mainstream medicine, You are no more going to be children of lesser God. I am blessed to get involved in this establishment of greater institution. First and foremost, I am a patient of Dr. Umesh. I was not ready to accept homeopathy medicine. It is my wife who has influenced me. Okkasari anna daggariki vellirandi. Nenu okkasari anna daggariki vachanu, permanent ga anna daggariki ayipoyam. The day one we came here to establish the college, there was nothing here. We have bought a small seat, but chinna mokka natinam. Ee roju mokka oka pedda vrikshamai ayi, 100 phalalu doctors vacharu, 100 doctors vacharu. And I feel proud that I am part of this system. I congratulate all the graduating students. Ayush was past, Ayush will be future. How many will accept? Because Dr. Praveen has clearly told with the data, Ayush was past and Ayush is going to be future. Thank you once again for giving me a great opportunity to address all the doctors. Thank you once again.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words. Your insights have added immense valuable to this momentous occasion. I would like to request Dr. Gnana Saujanya to speak on behalf of the graduating batch. Dr. Gnana Saujanya will deliver her speech.
అందరికీ నా హృదయపూర్వక నమస్కారములు. కెన్ యూ గైస్ రిపీట్ హాయ్ హాయ్ హలో హలో అగైన్ నైస్ నైస్ గుడ్ ఎనర్జీ. వేదికను అలంకరించినటువంటి గౌరవులైన ముఖ్య అతిథులకు, తదితర అతిథులకు, అలాగే గౌరవనీయులైన మన డైనమిక్ డైరెక్టర్ గారికి, అలాగే మన కళాశాలలో అతి ముఖ్యమైన పాత్ర వహించే ప్రిన్సిపల్ గారికి, అలాగే వైస్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ గారికి, అలాగే మాటలతో వర్ణించలేని ఘనత ఉన్న మన ఆచార్యులకు, సహాయాచార్యులకు మా అందరి హృదయపూర్వక నమస్కారములు. ఇంతటి గొప్పవారు చేరుకున్న ఈ ప్రాంగణం తారలు దిగివచ్చాయా అన్నట్టుగా అత్యంత ప్రకాశవంతంగా ఉండడానికి కారణం, yes, the only reason for all this shine and grind is the first ever graduating batch of Hamsa, the zestful Feronians 2K17. A big round of applause for all of us. For those who doesn't know me, people call me Pumpkin. Sometimes I may be called by the name Gnana Saujanya. Firstly, I would like to thank my parents and family for making me the person I am. And I would like to thank my dear fellow mates for giving me this great opportunity, being the voice of Feronians, for concluding all these years. It is today the day we are all awaiting for. Yes, we are graduating today. We have all started from zero, reached till here. From looking out for pretty and handsome people at the day one, and to admiring each other's insecurities, yes, we have reached till here. From fighting for the seats to standing for each other as one, we have reached till here. From sketching anatomy and histology to writing the log books, we have reached till here. From dreaming of becoming a doctor to actually becoming one, we have all reached still here. When I go back to the day one, we have all met. Strange place, strange campus, strange faces and people. We never knew we could become this intimate and affectionate to each other. All throughout this journey of 6 years of togetherness, we all have learned and acquired quite a lot. And before discussing all the formal things, I would like to first congratulate beforehand all our future personas. We have different kind of personas in our batch in future, which they may acquire. Firstly, I would like to congratulate many successful practitioners sitting over there and also some homeopaths. And there are few people who may
have the zest to create cult homeopathy. Can we name who are they? Okay. Let us not forget the future scientists, future MLAs, MPs, entrepreneurs, who may be coming back to college as guests. Like, who are they? Can you name? Most importantly, let us not congratulate the future PG aspirants or PG graduates, few insurance employees, future actors and models. Give it up for Vinaya, everyone. I wonder why did they join this course firsthand. Eventually, they may become, some of them may become housewife too. Dark, okay. Our badge has the most unique personalities, which I would like to discuss here today. Okay, guys, relax. I won't spill everything. I'm proud to say that our badge, we all are goal-oriented, punctual, diligent and hard-working, respectful, passionate, and attentive. Okay, let's come line by line, okay? Coming to the first one, goal-oriented. Can you name few of them? Okay, I can hear a few names. There are two types of goal-oriented people in our batch. Short-term goal-oriented and long-term goal-oriented. Jati Akash tries to do the short-term goal-oriented. Yes, yes. And whereas Nalini, like Tarun, like Chetan, they like to do the long-term oriented. Yes, yes, you got it. And coming to being punctual, who are they? Who are always punctual. Being on time is the challenging thing for them, which is the most important qualities. Yes, exactly. Chitla Vayana, Pranita and Anusha. Yes, they never miss any early events. They never miss any productive activities. True. And coming to the next quality, respectful. Okay. These guys have set an example for all of us about how to behave in class. Who are they? Okay. They are always serious in class and never made any fun and any jokes. Exactly. Sarika, Maliha, Deepika, give it up for them. They made classes very fun to all of us. Yes, and next coming to the next quality, being passionate. Who are they? These guys are so passionate that they never slept in class. They never did slept in class. Preetam, exactly. Preetam and Dr. Prasanna also. She has never slept in class. Okay. And coming to the next quality, diligent and hardworking. Who are they? Yes, a doctor should be diligent, which is the most important quality in his or her profession. He must know to overcome procrastination and laziness. And on a serious note, I would tell, this is all of us. This is definitely all of us. This is not a joke, but we are all are diligent and hardworking. That is what I can say, except for my best friends, Chandrika and Anita. And nextly, we must talk about the professors and lecturers who have shaped us to this perfection. On a serious note, on behalf of all Feronians, dear teachers, I sincerely thank you all for guiding us, for making a huge impact on us, for adding much value to our lives.
dear gurus, it is all your perseverance and a lot of sacrifices, your passionate teaching, standing for several hours to indulge knowledge, which made us to reach till here. We are all forever grateful and indebted to all of you. We wouldn't be what we are without you. At every patient we see, the skills you have taught us. Dear professors, we all admire for the deliberate kindness, love and support we have got from you. If I have to talk about the Ferronians, as Ferronians are known to be the best effective, potential, efficacious batch Hamsa could ever have. I'll tell you the reason why. We are nothing, we were nothing, we knew nothing when we came here. We were the first batch Hamsa has ever seen. We had no seniors to look up to. Indeed, we were the ones always looked up to. As the first batch of HHMC and RC, we have all equally taken the responsibility of setting a standard for rest of the batches. Of course, with a lot of support. Ferronians being the only batch have competed in sports very well enough in our first year and won several prizes at intercollege sports and marked our recognition. Whether it is extracurricular or curricular, we made our mark. We Ferronians have been an active part of Hamsa, conducting health camps, NSS camps, surveys covering most of the areas of Mulugu, Yadaram and Gajwel. Hamsa has won the fourth position in the intercollege sports conducted by KNR UHS. All the medical colleges have been taken part of Telangana. As being the only batch as major participants, we have won the fourth position. We still remember those days where we studied for the first year exams, not only for ourselves, but keeping in mind the future of HHMC is in our hands. Today, we, the batch of Ferronians, have published several articles in the renowned homeopathic journals. Several enthusiasts have shown their excellent credibility in STSH research projects. And each and every one of us has been a part of Dr. Weiser's research projects, that is osteoarthritis and maternal health projects. Today, myself, Dr. Jnana Saujanya, I am proud to say on this first graduation ceremony of HHMC and RC that I am a part of the first batch of Hamsa, which has been big whale and effective batch Hamsa could ever have. We are all those people who have seen the development of our college brick by brick. Yes, we came here alone, gained a family here. We are all happy that at least we are not leaving alone. We take with us the laughter, memories, fights, embarrassments, friendships, heartbreaks, life lessons, of course, lot of love and many more we have shaped together. All the pain, suffering and hardships we have faced are easy as we are all together for each other and stood together. It's hard to leave like this, but it is the time. I wish all the best for all my lovely friends. And I conclude by saying, we all remember HHMC and RC all through our lives. But more than that, I could say, Hamsa remembers the first batch of Ferronians for being us forever, ever and ever. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much, Saujanya, for refreshing all the memories. I feel honored to introduce our chief guest, A. Gopal Reddy Garu, Chairman, Constitution of Admission and Fee Regulatory Committee, Hyderabad, Chairman, High Power Committee. He is a great visionary and always an inspiration for the young generation. Hailing from a humble background, sir was enrolled as an advocate in the Bar Council of Andhra Pradesh in 1978 and joined in the office of Sri Upendra Lal Wagre, who was later elevated to the bench in 1983. Since then, he practiced independently in High Court and City Civil Court, Hyderabad. He was then appointed as Additional Central Government Standing Council in 1997 for 3 years. Later, he was appointed as Government Leader for Endowments, Forest, Environment and Energy for 3 years with effect from 1997. He was a Standing Council for Canara Bank Power Grid Corporation of India, seat India Limited Hyderabad, Public School Begumpet Ramanthapur Hyderabad, Andhra Mahila Sabha Arts and Science College Hyderabad, and panel advocate for State Bank of India and State Bank of Hyderabad. He has been appointed as the Appellate Authority for Industrial Finance and Reconstruction, New Delhi, and resigned for the said post in October 2012. Thereafter, Telangana government reconstituted High Power Committee with him as chairman from 2016 to till date. He continues to be the chairman High Power Committee government of Telangana and recently appointed as chairman Constitution of Admission and Fee Regulatory Committee Hyderabad. Now I request the Chief Guest Honorable Justice Sri A. Gopal Reddy Garu to deliver the convocation message to the graduating candidates. Sir, please.
Good evening to all of you. I deem it a matter of privilege, having been called upon to be the chief guest of graduation day of first batch of students. Students of Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College. Dignitaries on the dais, Dr. S. Praveen Kumar, Sri Acharya Garu, and President of the Institution, Dr. Umesh Garu, Principal Nurul Shehab Khan, Vice Principal Dr. Srinivas Garu, and all dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. When I and the students and the parents of the audience here, when I inspected the area as a first chairman of the High Power Committee of Telangana, first chairman of the Telangana, after seeing the construction activity, I was very much doubted whether the college can be established and it will run properly and educate the students, and whether they will get the admission of the students into this college. But when I called up, recently I inspected for enhancement of the seats, after seeing the tremendous development of the college, I congratulate the management for their relentless efforts for bringing this college to this level. But I could not have been here today, as the doctor invited me, because I still continue to be the chairman of the High Power Committee. Otherwise, whether he could have been called me or not, I was not aware. Immediately after taking the charge as AFRC in February, I requested the government to relieve me of this job. But there was an answer saying, sir, in view of the so many medical colleges, nobody will establish a medical college. Now almost 54 medical colleges are likely to be established in Telangana alone. So there is no purpose, there is no need, you can continue only as an in charge for enhancement of the seats by the High Power Committee chairman. since I accepted, I am here today before you. For establishment of any institution by philanthropist or any person, there are 3 D's which are necessary to be a successful, to make it successful. All the 3 D's are, one is decision or determination, nishchayam, nichita karya, nirnayam, that is what decision and determination. Then the second D is discipline, krama shikshana. Third D is dedication, ankita bhavam. Because the management of this institution has followed all the 3 D's to make the institution a successful institution today, to graduate students, first batch of students who are successfully graduated from this college. I congratulate all the students who are successful in the journey of this institution. A visionary can build a new organization in a scientific manner. Dr. Umesh Aiya to establish Homeopathy Medical College comes from the good thinking with thoughts, highest ideals to educate people. Then he took the decision with determination and followed the discipline and dedication. I congratulate him and all the management to bringing this educational institution. The students who have to know that every successful man must have behind him somewhere tremendous sincerity, and that is the cause of his signal of success in life. If he had been perfectly unselfish, he would have great success as that of Buddha. The degree of unselfish makes the degree of success everywhere in any profession. To achieve what was decided, Swami Vivekananda, I quote here one, what he quoted is, we explain the education. What is an education? Education is not learning. It is not even a diverse knowledge, the training by which correct and expression will are under control and become fruitful is called education. The Hamsa Medical College has trained the students as fruitful students of the society, fruitful doctors of the society after the completion of graduation today, after they obtained the certificates. The real education is that which enables one to stand on his own legs. All the students, now they are able to stand on their own legs after going out from this college. I wish them all success. Education is another fact that it is manifestation of perfection already possessed by man. Man includes woman. What is a perfection possessed by a man means there is a lot of this thing. When I was a student in 1971, I was very fond of even late Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. He addressed the Kesho Memorial Education Grounds saying that he was saying in Hindi, Har talwar mein tez chupi hui hai. All iron, even iron blade will have sharpness in it. Ragad ragadne mein tez aati hai. So we have to bring the sharpness by hard working, length of hard working. So mere becoming a doctor is not sufficient that you have attained perfection unless you have strenuously practiced the same as doctors earlier said it. To become a successful doctor, I congratulate the students who are completed this undergraduate course today. Dear student, I put another quotation. We are responsible. That is also Swami Vivekananda. We are responsible for what we are and whatever we wish ourselves to be. We have the power to make ourselves. All the students should remember it. If what we are now is being the result of our own past actions, because we have studied for 5 years and you have completed your graduation, this is the past, now you are a graduate. It certainly follows that whatever we wish to be in future can be produced by our present action. So all the students have to know how to act in future. So, and unless you have a sincere hard work and dedicated to the job, you cannot become a successful man in any walks of life. I simply give one example. As the student just now said, the fun they had in the during their education of all these 5 years, all the students. But this is now, it is a past. In future, you have to be very serious to become in your life, and you have to be a successful citizen, and you are then only successful doctor, then only you can contribute to the nation. I wish all the students thanks, and I should wish all the students successful career in the future. I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity. I thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words.
Now I request the president of today's program, our beloved director, Dr. Umesh Akkaladevi, sir, to deliver the presidential message to the graduates. Can we have all the graduating students in their seats, please? Can I have all the graduating students in their seats, please? All the graduating students, please come back to your positions. We will end the program soon. All the graduating students, please come back to your position. Can we have all the graduating students back to their positions, please? One last call.
అయ్యో ఏంది సైమల్టేనియస్ రెండింటికి రికార్డ్ అవుతుందా ఇది కార్డు ఏబీల రెండింటిలో అవుతున్నట్టుంది
లేదు లేదు
ఒకదాంతో
and now all the parents I request to bear with us for next 10 minutes we will be ending the program soon you have all the time to take photographs it is not a good thing to leave the arena when the guests are still here
okay
we have not taught this indiscipline in the last 6 years
and I would not bear with any kind of such misbehavior. I have a commitment when I have started. Of our first graduating class, 98 remarkable healers. As president of this to nurture compassionate caregivers inspired by the gentle principles of homeopathy. Today, that vision stands before us, materialized in the form of these radiant graduates. A big round of applause for the successful achievement of the most important thing in their life. To the esteemed faculty, my heartfelt gratitude for your dedication and wisdom. You have been the architects of these young minds, shaping them into skilled practitioners and compassionate individuals. Especially in the last 1 month of our unique internship completion program, which we coined the name as Past Forward. That is, whatever they have learnt in the last 5.5 years, the last 1 month was a quick redo of all the departments, all the skills that might be necessary for them to jump into the life and start from day one. This was the mission we started this college with the support of all my beloved friend, Sri Joginpalli Santosh Kumar, and with just a one word of my asking that the new state of Telangana requires a good homeopathy college, and being a homeopathy physician myself, wanted to see a good college in this newly formed state. With just one request, and within just 15 minutes, he said, go ahead. And here we are, the first batch is coming out, and every year there will be a new batch coming out of 100 doctors. All the distinguished guests who are sitting here on this dais, they have been playing a vital part in bringing up this institution. Right from Honorable Justice Gopal Reddy sir, as he himself said, he was in doubt whether this institution can come up with an infrastructure and faculty and educational resources that can produce 100 doctors per year. There was a doubt anybody who has come onto this campus. But with great vision and determination that we would soon surpass all the obstacles and challenges, and without the support of my good friend Joganpally Santosh Kumar, I would not have been done this. To the proud families, if you can remember, each and every one of you, I met you 6 years ago. And I thank you for the trust. The young institution, which had a minimum infrastructure and a minimum faculty, but you could trust me with my word that I will give back to you after 6 years, which will, you know, like, be way ahead of your expectations. You need a doctor, but I'm giving you the healers. Each one of them has been trained. I tell this with utmost confidence. I'm giving back to you your child 6 years ago, who was just a intermediate passed out, just neat written, passed out with no knowledge, to a full-blown doctors who could take up any challenging case. From day one, I used to challenge them. Homeopathy is one science which everybody will look up to, and it is going to be the future of medicine, not just because I am practicing, but the way it is growing. Most of you parents, 6 years ago, you had no choice. MBBS was not there with you. They could not get the rank, or you people could not afford the fees of MBBS seat. That you have chosen this, and each and every one of them accepts that. But right from day one, that was my ambition, that was my vision, that the idea should change. And the change comes from a spark which will ignite, and it will become a full-blown fire, and that fire of knowledge and that aim to cure the sick in this suffering society, they will, each one of them, become a torchbearer, and they will deliver what they are graduating today. I could say this with 100% assurance, and nobody else other than me would be the most happiest and proud person standing here on this day to look at this young talent. Yes, they are very talented, but as all young minds get a little carried away here and there, and it is our duty as elders to bring them back to the track. We have not left any chance of getting them deviated from what their aim was or what their goal was. Yes, we could brick by brick build in the last 6 years, and my effort in letting them see the complete development on this campus before they leave has been accomplished. And again, with their great support and with the support of my faculty, we have achieved this. I know this is a little emotional, but that is what we had with the first batch of the 100 students we had. Me and my wife Padmaja, we considered these 100 students not as students but our own children. We have nurtured them, we have given that care and guidance as a mother would give. Do you accept children? Thank you for the trust in me, dear parents, and I'm giving back to you what you have hoped for, or I hope I'm giving you back much more than what you have expected for. Okay, now coming to my dear graduates, then directly I would like to talk my heart out, but I fear that I would break with emotional love. Yeah, I'm already. So I have just written what I would like to say to you. I'll just read out, because if I start speaking and definitely I would break down here. Because that is the emotional connect I have with you. You all know that. My dear graduates, you have embarked on a truly special journey. You have delved into the intricacies of a holistic medical science, embracing its focus on healing the mind, body, and spirit in profound synergy. Remember, your role is not just to treat symptoms, but to unravel the emotions of each patient's story, understand their unique needs, and guide them towards holistic well-being. The road ahead will be paved with challenges and triumphs, uncertainties and breakthroughs. Embrace them all with the spirit you nurtured within these four sides of the campus. Let your stethoscope be a conduit, not just for diagnosing maladies, but for listening to the whispers of hope and resilience within each patient. Let your touch be a source of comfort, your words a balm, and your presence a testament to the healing power of human connection. Remember, you are not merely doctors, you are ambassadors of a revolution in healthcare. You carry the torch of a practice that emphasizes prevention, empowers patients, and respects the interconnectedness of our existence. Carry this torch with pride, illuminating the path for future generations of healers. As you step out into the world, remember to carry with you not just the knowledge and skills you have honed here, but also the spirit of this place. Let the bonds forged within this campus remain unbreakable. Stay connected. Reach out to each other in times of need and celebration. Make time for alumni meets. Share your experiences with your juniors and guide them on their own journeys. Remember, Hamsa Homeopathy Medical College is not just an institution, it's your family. You will always have a home here, not just in these buildings, but in the hearts of your faculty, your peers, and all those who have witnessed your transformation. Come back to reminisce, to inspire, to be inspired. Your success is our success. Your joy is our joy. And to our bright-eyed juniors, we have another batch coming into the internship now. It is for you. Look upon these graduates with wonder and anticipation. Their paths are yours to follow. Their triumphs are yours to aspire to. Learn from their dedication, their compassion, their unwavering spirit. They are the torch bearers and you are the future. So dear graduates, as you embark on this incredible journey, know that you are not alone. You carry within you the legacy of Hamsa, the love of your families, and the unwavering support of your alma mater. Go forth, healers, change makers, light bearers. May your lives be a testament to the transformative power of medicine and the enduring spirit of this very special place. This is not a goodbye. Is it a goodbye? It's merely see you soon. Congratulations and welcome back as always. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir, for your enlightening speech. Your words have left a lasting impact on this special day. Now I request Dr. Gautam and Dr. Pragna to take over felicitation of guests on the stage.
Hi.
Good evening, one and all. Myself, Dr. Pragna, Assistant Professor in Department of Organic Medicine.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Dr. Gautam Ralabandi, Assistant Professor, Department of Repertory. Now, we shall proceed for felicitation. I request our beloved Dr. Padmaja Madam to accompany our Director, Dr. Umesh Akkaladevi, to felicitate our Honorable Chief Guest, Justice A. Gopal Reddy Garu. I request the dignitaries on the dais to please join the felicitation.
Chandu Krish.
A huge round of applause from the audience.
Okay.
Now I request Dr. Padmaja Ma'am, Dr. Umesh sir to felicitate our guest of honor, Dr. Praveen Kumar sir, accompanied by the dignitaries.
May I request Dr. Padmaja Madam and Dr. Umesh sir to felicitate our guest of honor, Sri Srinivas Acharya sir, accompanied by the dignitaries on the dais. Some huge round of applause from the audience. The new graduates, make some noise. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Now, I request Dr. Yamuna Abbagala to deliver the word of thanks.
Good evening, everyone. I, Dr. Yamuna, Assistant Professor, Department of Pathology, it gives me an immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks for this event to all the dignitaries present here. I would like to thank our Chief Guest, Justice A. Gopal Reddy Garu, who honored this function. And I would like to thank Guest of Honor, Dr. S. Praveen Kumar Garu, T. Srinivas Acharya Garu, and I would also like to thank our beloved chairperson, Sri Joginipalli Santosh Kumar Garu, Srimati Rohini Garu, our dynamic directors, Dr. Umesh Akkaladevi Garu, Dr. Padmaja Madam, and our principal ma'am, Nooru Sehar Khan Ma'am, Vice Principal Sir, Dr. Srinivas Babu Katti Sir, our staff, faculty, students, volunteers, and each and everyone
who directly and indirectly participated in this event and made it a grand success. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Srinivas Pathi Babu sir to conclude the program. Thank you, everyone.
So, dear doctors, with the permission of honorable guests and all the dignitaries, sir, permit me, I can call my first batch students as a doctor. Thank you, sir. Dear doctors, how are you?
Solo, bro.
2017 అడ్మిషన్స్ కి మీ పిల్లలతో పాటు అసలు హోమియోపతి చదివించాలా వద్దా, కొత్త కాలేజీ, మా పిల్లల భవిష్యత్ ఎట్లా ఉంటుంది అని ఫస్ట్ బ్యాచ్ పేరెంట్స్ చాలా మందికి నేను కౌన్సిలింగ్ లో ఉన్నాను. ఫస్ట్ బ్యాచ్ స్టూడెంట్స్, ప్రతి విషయంలో మీరు కాలేజీలో జరుగుతున్న ప్రతి ఈవెంట్ కానీ యాక్టివిటీ కానీ మీ సపోర్ట్తో ఈరోజు సక్సెస్ఫుల్గా ఒక బ్యాచ్ని మీరు మాకు ఆ రోజు ముడి సరుకుని మీ పిల్లలని మాకు తీసుకొచ్చి ఇచ్చారు. ఈరోజు అంతకంటే శక్తివంతంగా సమాజానికి సేవ చేయడానికి హోమియోపతి వైద్యం ద్వారా నిరంతరం ప్రతి పనిలో మమ్మల్ని వెన్నంటి ప్రోత్సహిస్తున్న మా డైరెక్టర్ డాక్టర్ ఉమేష్ గారు అండ్ డైరెక్టర్ డాక్టర్ పద్మజ మేడం గారు, ప్రిన్సిపల్ అండ్ ఆల్ మై ఫ్యాకల్టీ మెంబర్స్, అడుగడుగున నేను అనుకుంటాను ఇది మీకు నిర్దేశించిన కాలానికి కానీ ఈ కళాశాలలో ఇచ్చిన ఒక 5.5 సంవత్సరాల కాలం మీ డాక్టర్స్ అవ్వడానికి, కానీ ఇది మీకు చివరి రోజు కాదు. ఇంకా బయట ఫ్యూచర్లో మీకు ప్రతి విషయానికి హంస హోమియోపతి మెడికల్ కళాశాలలో ఉన్న ప్రతి ఒక్కరూ మీకు మీ లైఫ్ టైం ప్రతి విషయంలో గైడ్ చేస్తారని, మీకు ప్రతి విషయంలో ఫ్యూచర్ మీరు ఎలా ఉండాలి, మీకున్న ఇక్కడున్న ఫ్యాకల్టీ వాళ్ళ యొక్క ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ మీకు ఇచ్చి మిమ్మల్ని సమాజంలో పేరున్న డాక్టర్గా, తల్లిదండ్రులారా, ఒకరోజు ఇన్ని రోజులు మీరు కేర్ ఆఫ్ అని మీ పేరు రాసుకున్నారు తర్వాత పలాని డాక్టర్ వాళ్ళ ఆమె మా పాప, ఆమె మా బాబు అనేట్టుగా వాళ్ళకి ట్రైనింగ్ ఇచ్చారని గర్వంగా చెప్పుకుంటున్నా నేను. మీరున్న ఊర్లలో మీ సమాజంలో మీరున్న ప్రాంతంలో వాళ్ళకున్న తెలివి ద్వారా మీరు కష్టాన్ని మీ యొక్క పేరు ప్రఖ్యాతల్ని వాళ్ళు ఇంకా ఎక్కువ చేసి హోమియోపతి చదివించి మేము చాలా గొప్ప పని చేశాము అనే నమ్మకము ఇక్కడున్న అందరు స్టూడెంట్స్ లో నేను చూశాను. డియర్ పేరెంట్స్,
మీరు వాళ్ళ యొక్క ఫ్యూచర్ ప్లాన్స్ ని ఇంతే ఎంకరేజ్ చేయండి. వాళ్ళకి ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయడానికి, వాళ్ళని హోమియోపతిలో పీజీ చేయడానికి, వాళ్ళ హోమియోపతిలో ఫ్యూచర్ చేయడానికి ఇప్పుడు ఎంత ప్రోత్సాహం ఇచ్చారో అంత ప్రోత్సాహం ఇస్తారని చివరిసారిగా మిమ్మల్ని రిక్వెస్ట్ చేస్తున్నాను. ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ ద ప్రెసిడెంట్ టు డిక్లేర్ ద కాన్వకేషన్ డిజాల్వ్ బై రింగింగ్ ద గాంగ్. I request to all to rise for national anthem.
జనగణ మన అధినాయక జయ హే భారత భాగ్య విధాతా పంజాబ్ సింధు గుజరాత మరాఠా ద్రావిడ ఉత్తర వంగా వింధ్య హిమాచల యమునా గంగా ఉజ్జల జగధి తరంగా తవ శుభ నామే జాగే తవ శుభ ఆశిష మాగే గాహే తవ జయగాథా జనగణ మంగళ దాయక జయ హే భారత భాగ్య విధాతా జయ హే జయ హే జయ హే
ఇంకా ఇప్పుడు
అరే సాయి సాయి పరిగెత్తుకోండి నువ్వు సంగతి వచ్చారు జల్ది
ఏంటది అర్థం కాదు ఇది అయిపోయిందాయిందాయి
ఒక్క నిమిషం ఒక్క నిమిషం
జాగ్రత్త జాగ్రత్త
ఓకేనా
థైరాయిడ్ వస్తే బాగుంటుంది ఇంకా ఆశ్రయం కొట్టుకున్నట్టు ఓన్లీ సైడ్
సాయిగాడు ఏం చేస్తుంటారు వీళ్ళు ఉండాలి కదా అంతవరకు అబ్బాయి
ఇరియా
Centuries ago, is a gentle reminder to protect the human race against all odds. Yes, homeopathy is your only hope to connect with nature and enduring the all-natural restoration of health. Blended with roots, tradition, and heritage.
This unit was not disturbed. This unit was a well thought out process to give an unparalleled quality. The quality which was earlier anticipated only from an international brand. I foresee a bright future for Advan as well as the Indian homeopathic industry. and I wish to work with the industry to dominate the Indian as well as the international market. Thank you.
Yes, Advan is working hard to make healthcare look more understandable, approachable, accessible, and of course, affordable. Affordability is the key when Advan touches not only the mindset, but also the heart of every Indian. Our commitment is backed by India's most advanced and automated manufacturing facility, spread across a sprawling 65,000 square feet of area, where we practice highly stringent quality systems for every manufacturing process, along with GMP guidelines and the validation system to commit the quality for which we are known.
Today we can say proudly that we are India's fastest growing homeopathic company with most advanced manufacturing unit, and we can also claim that we are the trendsetters. Thank you.
Our manufacturing facility also follows the universal laws of life. It has been designed in such a way that all the five tattvas have been taken into consideration. Jal, Vayu, Akash, Agni, and Prithvi. All of them play an important part in defining the quality of products that come out of our manufacturing unit. Our scientifically advanced setup and stringent protocols keep our product free from any sort of contamination whilst keeping top-notch quality standards. With a laboratory spread over a sprawling 3,500 square feet of area, without a doubt, we have one of the very best infrastructures in the country when it comes to quality. Within the house, we have a high-end microbial laboratory as well. Adding to the reputation, we are going for the prestigious NABL accreditation of our laboratory to ensure we deliver only the best.
I feel very proud and happy to be associated with such prestigious Indian homeopathic brand, that is Advan.
Advan leads the homeopathic market with over 400 mother tinctures, including the rare ones, and over 2,500 dilutions of various potencies. Advan has also diversified its operations into quality personal care products for hair, skin, and oral hygiene under the brand of Advan Naturals. The core of any quality product are the ingredients used, and we very well understand the essence.
I request you.